Hello, this is RetroTK2, and today you'll learn some of the more moderate operators in C#. These are operators that are not quite complicated enough to put in the advanced category, but can still cause you a little bit of trouble. You'll see the final multiplicative operator, two of the primary operators, two unary operators, and a load of assignment operators. I'm sure you're as excited as I am, Ace. As always, I'd encourage you to check out the channel files that accompany this video. Card should be on your screen now. So let's get started. The first operator we'll look at is the last multiplicative operator called modulus. It is denoted with a percentage symbol, and according to MSDN, the modulus operator computes the remainder after dividing its first operand by its second. All numeric types have predefined remainder operators. Super, that's cleared everything up nicely, yes. Well, maybe if we look at an example, it'll become a little bit clearer. Open up Unity and create a basic C# script. As always, Ace, make sure the script has a different name than any other class in your project. Here I'm going to use the modulus operator to find the remainder when 5 is divided by 2. Save the script, head back into Unity, drag the script onto a game object in your scene, and run the game. And you'll see that 1 is logged. With me so far, Ace? 2 doesn't divide into 5 evenly, but it does divide evenly into 4 to give 2. Taking 4 away from 5 gives us a remainder of 1, and so 1 is logged. Let's try another one. How about 4 modulus 2? What do we expect the remainder to be, yes? Save the script, head back into Unity, and rerun the game. And you'll see that 0 was logged to the console, since 4 divided by 2 leaves no remainder. Easy peasy, yes. You can use the modulus operator on other numeric types as well. Let's get the modulus of 125.678 and 8.93. Save, head back into Unity, and rerun the game. And you'll see that 0.658000000000001 is logged. There's our rounding errors coming into play again, yes? We'll leave them there for now. Let's take a look at two primary operators and two unary operators. They are the prefix increment, denoted by a plus plus before the operand. That's the number in this case, yes? The prefix decrement, denoted by a minus minus before the operand. The postfix increment, denoted by a plus plus after the operand. And the postfix decrement, denoted by a minus minus after the operand. All very similar, yes. According to MSDN, the decrement operator, minus minus, decrements its operands by 1. The decrement operator can appear before or after its operand, minus minus variable and variable minus minus. The first form is a prefix decrement operation. The result of the operation is the value of the operand after it has been decremented. The second form is a postfix decrement operation. The result of the operation is the value of the operand before it has been decremented. The increment operator is similar, yes, except instead of decrementing by 1, it's incremented by 1. The prefixes are unary operators, and the postfixes are primary operators. Let's have a look at these in action. It's worth noting here is that these operators can't be used on literals. If I type out 1 with the postfix increment operator, you'll see we get an error. The left-hand side of an assignment must be a variable, property, or indexer. This is the main reason I made the basic variable declaration video is. The card is on the screen now in case you've missed it. Declare a basic variable of type int and give it whatever value you like is. First, let's see the prefix operators in action since they're the easiest to demonstrate. Save, head back into Unity, and rerun the game. And you'll see that 2 is logged, and so is 1. 2 is logged first since 1 plus 1 equals 2, and 1 is logged after since 2 minus 1 equals 1. Fairly basic, yes, but let's try it with the postfix operators. Copy this block of code and paste it just below. and change the x to a y variable. And add in your postfix operators. Save, head back into Unary, and yeah, you know what to do, yes. Now one is logged first, and then two. What's going on here is, like MSDN said, we are seeing the results before they have been incremented and decremented. So y has a value of 1 initially. We apply a post increment and log y as well. This means that the value of y before the increment is logged, which is 1. Then the value is incremented by 1. So now, coming into the second log, y has a value of 2 and we want to apply a postfix decrement and log. What happens? Y's current value is logged, which is 2, and then the value is incremented by 1. Confused, Ace? Well, if we log y straight afterwards, like so, it should log 1. Save, head back into Unity, and rerun the game. And you'll see that 1 is logged, 2 is logged, and then 1 is logged again. I personally don't use the prefix operators like this here, since it usually leads to confusion pretty quickly. Instead, I usually spread them out so that the variable's value is in the most up-to-date state. Let me show you this. Declare another basic variable and give it whatever name you like. Just make sure the name is different than any other previously defined variables. Here I've called mine Z and given it a value of 100. So that we can see it clearly in the log. I want to log Z's current value now and I want to increment it by 1, then I want to log its value after. To do that, I log out Z, like so is, then put Z++ below it, and then log out it out again. Save, head back into Unity, and rerun the game. And you'll see that 100 is logged and 101 is logged. No confusion, Ace. Well, perhaps a little. Anyway, moving on to our last operators of the day, the assignment operators. We've already seen the equals assignment operator in action, but we can prefix it with some of our familiar mathematic operations from earlier videos. To check those videos out, click the card on your screen now, Ace. So okay, let's declare another variable a and give it the value 3. We seen in the last video that we could perform mathematical operations on a to change its value and reassign it. Like so is. If I save, head back into Unity, and rerun the game, 6 is logged. All stuff we've seen before, but we can get the same result with less code is. Using the plus equals assignment operator, we can rewrite our code to look like this. A plus equals 3. From MSDN, the increment operator will add the value of y to the value of x, store the results in x, and return the new value. You can log the result directly if you prefer, yes, but I personally don't. I usually like to keep my operations separate and where I can see them. Your preferences may vary. You can use other mathematical operations in the same way to create an assignment operator for that operation. So instead of plus 3, let's try minus 3, multiplied by 2, divided by 2, and modulus 4. Also, don't forget to add the debug logs to each and every one of these, yes. Save, head back into Unity, and rerun the game. And we get 6, 3, 6, 3, and 3. Isn't it great, yes? You can also add variables to each other and even apply operations to them. Just remember your BODMIS and you should be absolutely fine, yes. Remember to log out the a variable. Save, head back in, yada yada. And hey, 183 is logged. This has been a good look at some of the moderately challenging operators in C#. And that's it. Rate, comment, and subscribe, yes. I hope you're liking this series. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com with your C# experiences. Thank you for watching, yes, and I'll see you in the next video.